Vsauce, I'm Jake, and recently I've been playing a lot of Borderlands the Pre-Sequel, which takes place on a lunar colony that has a lot of similar characteristics to our own moon. And it got me thinking about how mankind has always dreamed of colonizing the moon. Back in 1638, Bishop John Wilkins wrote about humanity living on the moon. In the 1950s and 60s, the US government created numerous proposals detailing just that, like the US Army's Project Horizon in 1959, which outlined a military base on the moon by 1966, or the US Air Force's LUMIX project to create an underground Air Force base. And in 2006, NASA proposed to build a lunar outpost by 2024. But what if we actually did? What would it be like on Earth's only natural satellite? What if we lived on the moon? One of the first things you would notice is the sun and how white it would be. Because there's only an extremely thin layer of gas surrounding the moon, an exosphere, there is no real atmosphere to absorb and scatter sunlight, which is also the reason why the lunar sky is just black. You'd also have a hard time seeing any stars because the sun is so much brighter than they are. It's the reason there are no visible stars in the background of photos from the Apollo missions. A lunar day would be a lot longer as well. It would last 29 Earth days, with 14 and a half of them being in sunshine, and the other 14 and a half being in darkness. And even though the moon and Earth are pretty equal in terms of distance to the sun, the lack of atmosphere on the moon means that the temperatures would change dramatically, going from 240 degrees during the day to negative 280 at night. And then there are parts of the moon that are perpetually dark. Deep craters around the poles may never see sunlight, and the coldest temperature ever recorded in our solar system so far was inside one of them. The coldest natural recording on Earth was in Antarctica at negative 135.8 degrees. It is believed that within these craters there's water ice, which would allow us to get H2O directly from the moon, instead of the incredible cost of having it sent from Earth. On the opposite side of the spectrum are parts of the moon that are exposed to direct sunlight over 80% of the time. These extremely long hours of daylight and darkness would not only throw us out of sync with the Earth, but could mess with our bodies. Midnight suns can cause sleep disturbance, hyperactivity, fatigue, and irritable moods, whereas polar nights can lead to feelings of sadness, lack of energy, difficulty staying awake, and craving carbohydrates. Since we'd be on a different time than the citizens of Earth, we'd need a way to keep track of it. In 1970, astronomer Kenneth L. Franklin created a watch for people who visited the moon. It told time in lunations, which were equal to 29 and a half Earth days. If you didn't have a moon watch, another way to tell time would be by using the cycles of the Earth's phases, just like we use the moons to create a lunar calendar. And because these two celestial bodies are tidally locked to each other, we would see all of the Earth's phases in one lunar day, and it would look something like this. Almost four times bigger than the moon. So during an eclipse, the sun would make a red ring around the Earth for hours. Besides the effects of long days and long nights on us mentally, the difference in gravity would change us physically. We know that the human body and microgravity causes bone loss and the wasting away or atrophy of muscles. Luckily, the moon has 1/6 the gravity of Earth, so you'd be able to lift a small cow. And also, these effects on your body would happen less quickly than, say, to an astronaut on the International Space Station. But a benefit of being on the ISS is that you age less. After 6 months on the ISS, the astronauts are 0.0007 seconds younger than if they had stayed on Earth. However, on the moon, you'd age faster. Einstein said that time is a river. It can speed up at certain points and slow down at others. Because of time dilation, time would be going faster on the moon. So if you stayed there for a year, you'd be 0.002 seconds older than on Earth. And after 80 years, you'd be 0.16 seconds older. Also, there are those doses of radiation you'd be blasted with because of the whole no atmosphere thing. So why not make an atmosphere on the moon? The big issues would be the solar wind that would slowly whisk it away, and according to the Hoxima study that looked into creating a lunar atmosphere, it would take about a century to create one that was stable. However, it wouldn't be breathable at a pressure 1/10,000,000th that of Earth's. It would actually be the same as the Kármán line, the altitude at which outer space technically begins. Even if we were able to put a breathable atmosphere on the moon, it would only last 100 years before we would have to replenish it. So, space suits and biodomes are going to be necessary for our moon adventures for some time. However, the silver lining to all of this is going to the moon's highest point, which at 35,387 feet makes it 6,300 feet taller than Everest. And once there, firing a tank. Why fire a tank, you ask? Well, that bullet you just shot is now orbiting the moon. Just be sure to move out of the way an hour and 49 minutes later when it comes back around. And as always, thanks for watching.